So we need to make a flow chart. So the first thing we need to do is generate random number for weather. So once we generate random number, then we ask a question about the weather, whether it will be good or not. So we are asking a question. So we have this diamond. If it is no, then we use distribution for bad weather. However, if the answer is yes, so if the weather is good, we use distribution for good weather, and then we generate a random number for demand. And after using distribution for bad weather, this line comes here. Now the next question we ask is whether demand is greater than what number is available. If the answer is no, then we have sales equal to demand. If the answer is yes, then we have sales equals number available. And then we again ask the question, if we have simulated enough days. If the answer to this question is yes, then we have completed simulation and we can stop. Now this line here will join in at this location. But if the answer to this question is no, then we go back to generating random number for weather here. So this will complete the flow chart for part C. So you have from to information. So the first one is from initial exam to x-ray, or a patient can go to operating theater, or may go to observation, or done and out processing. So in this case, so these are cumulative probabilities, and your random interval will look like this. So 1 to 45, 46 to 60, 61 to 70, 71 to 00. This is what is available. So we have converted information available to cumulative probabilities and random number interval. Now for simulating, we can make this table. So we can say need person. So if you take the first patient, and if you look at the random number table, we have 52. So this 52 means 52 will be somewhere here. So a patient will go to operating room. The next random number is 37. So the patient is in operating room. So operating means here. 37 means 37 is somewhere here. So that means the patient will go to observation. Next 82, and from observation, which is here, 82 means this block. So the patient will be out, and that will complete simulation for the first one. Then we go to the next patient, and random number is 69. So this patient again starts with initial exam, and 69 is somewhere here. So the patient will go to observation. So the patient is simulated to go to observation, and the next random number is 98. So from observation, if you look at again at the bottom, so 98 is here, so the patient is out. So this patient is lucky, so two trips and out. Similarly, third patient, random number 96. So from initial exam, 96 means this one. So this patient is out just after one trip to initial exam. So this way, you can simulate 10 patients.